I'm actually going to be doing my October favorites today. I know I'm a little late, but I have had midterms this week and I got really, really sick. So I was kind of waiting for my voice to come back. But to start off really quickly, so that I won't take you guys' time, I'm really going to start off with a moisturizer that I've been applying basically daily. And it's something that I really don't do all the time. I actually don't apply moisturizer every day just because I am in a hurry to get to class. But recently my face has been very dry lately. I don't know if it's because of the weather, because it's been hot and then cold and hot and cold, or really hot or really cold. But I've been applying my moisturizer a lot daily and it's been preventing especially this area around my nose from cracking. I don't know if that I'm even saying it correctly, but it tends to kind of dry a lot around my nose. So I've been putting this all over my face before I apply either BB cream or foundation, and it's been really, really helping my skin kind of get the moisture it needs on a daily basis. But basically, it's the Neutrogena oil-free moisturizer, and I believe you can get this basically anywhere. It's actually really good. It hydrates your skin really well. It doesn't leave it oily like many moisturizers do, and it lets you apply the makeup very, very quickly and very flawless on your face. The next product that I really wanted to speak of is a hair product, and it's just because my straightener actually recently died on me, so I haven't really had such a great straightener or basically anything to dry my hair with or put it down with. So I've been putting it a lot on a bun lately. And it's been really moisturizing my hair and at the same time letting it not frizz up, because I do have basically curly hair. It's not wavy and it's not curly, it's in between. So it's like just curly, but not mega curly. But this is what I've been applying to my hair, and it's actually a split end protector. So normally what I do is I just apply it all the way in the ends of my hair when I get out of the shower, or if I wake up and I just want to put it up in a bun, I kind of just apply a lot of it in my hair. And I feel that when I do, say, take down my bun and I go into the shower, it actually feels really, really moisturized, as opposed to when I straighten it on a daily basis and I'm just running my fingers through my hair and it feels pretty dry. So that's actually been helping my hair, I think, get back to its healthy self. But it's called the Aussie Hair Insurance Split End Protector, just so you guys know, and it looks like this. So, I guess I don't know, I've been going towards that brand lately because I did like the hairspray, but that's that. The next product I'm going to be showing you guys is a product that I did do on my MAC haul, and I didn't know if I was going to like it, but I've actually been using this a lot lately, and it's the MAC Prep and Prime Translucent Powder or Finishing Powder. It's the pressed powder version, it's not the loose version. And I did get this pressed powder version just because I didn't want to, say, throw it in my makeup kit and all the powder just fall down. So that's basically why I got this. I don't know what the difference between the loose and the pressed powder is. I'm assuming it's just because this one's pressed down and the other one is loose. So I actually really like it. I have it on my face right now, and it's on top of the foundation that I'm actually using. It is very, very translucent. It actually doesn't leave that white coat that some translucent powders do have, or maybe I just haven't noticed it because I do spray Fix Plus on top of all of my makeup. But it's actually been really good to me, so I really, really like it, and I recommend it to people who are interested in trying a translucent powder. Or you can just get a more affordable one. I actually wanted to try either if e.l.f. had one, just to see if, you know, it's very similar or not. But the next thing I want to talk about is an eyeshadow that I've been using on a daily basis. And I've been using it since I haven't really had time to be doing my makeup, especially during this week since it was midterms week for me. I've been just really loosely applying it and putting on mascara and just going to class. So it's the MAC Amber Lights eyeshadow. And I actually have to get a new one because it's cracked and it's basically on its last days that I have it. So it looks like that, and I'm just gonna grab a little just because I don't really wanna waste the product anymore. It gives this really shiny finish. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I've been using it a lot on my eyes and it's really, really pretty. I normally use that, and then I use another brown color just to kind of crease my eye. And you know, it's really good that you don't have to really blend it. It kind of does it itself. So again, that's called Ember Lights. And the next products I'm going to be talking about is actually two lipsticks that I've been really gravitating towards a lot during this week and this month. And they're basically, I guess, because they're fall colors. One of the lipsticks is actually from Wet n Wild, and it is the one that I have on my lips right now. It's number 913C, and it's by Wet n Wild. It's actually like $1 or $2, max $3. This is how it looks like. It's a orangey tint, and just so you guys can see it, this is how it looks. And it's a really pretty color for the fall, so I've been really loving it on my lips lately. Every time I actually wear it, my boyfriend's like, did you do something different to your makeup routine? And I'm like, no, I just applied lipstick. But anyways, the next product that I'm going to be talking about is a Riri lipstick that I really, really, really like. It is the Retro Matte Riri Boy, and it is a very pretty purple. And I actually used this on my, I think my eyeliner tutorial that I showed you guys. But it's a really pretty purple, and it looks like this. It's really, 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 really pretty. And it's really pretty for the fall. It was two products, just these two lipsticks. So one, I guess, more high-end, and a very, very inexpensive one. The next ones are palettes. I'm bringing these palettes out to show to you guys just because I did do two Halloween tutorials, and I used them a lot during those tutorials. So I think they need some credit for this month. It is the BH Party Girl palette, and it has all of these colors. Excuse the mess, but I still need to clean all my makeup from all the mess that I made for my Halloween tutorials. It has all of these colors, and I did use most of them this month, except I think the pinks. I didn't really use them. I do also use them for school, say the lighter versions, like this, and sometimes I use this to highlight. And of course, I use this one for my Sugar Skull tutorial. But I think this needs some credit, and I remember I got it really cheap, and I was really excited when BH Cosmetics actually came out with it. So that's really affordable and inexpensive, so you guys should totally check that out. And the next palette is the Bare palette by Sigma. I actually got this at IMATS about a year ago in last year's IMATS, and it was my first time going. I was really excited because I met Carly Bell, and I thought she was adorable. But this is how the palette looks like. And this is super dirty because I need to clean it. But anyways, it has all of these nude colors, and that's normally what I use on a daily basis. And the colors are extremely pigmented, which I really, really like. And I did not know what to expect from Sigma, so I was a little bit iffy on it since it did come out, I think, during the same time as the Naked palette. But it was a little bit cheaper. The next product that I'm going to be talking about is a product that I think a lot of people have been talking about recently, either on Instagram or on YouTube. I actually wanted to try it myself, so I ended up buying it just to see if it was worth it. At first, I'm not going to lie, the first two tries that I actually went through with it, I didn't really notice any results. Well, at least I didn't. My boyfriend told me that he totally noticed something, but I don't know if I guess I was just expecting more for the first two tries. I wasn't really excited the first two tries, but then after like the fifth try, I was like, wow, my teeth are actually really, really, really white now. But it's the Dial a Smile, and I actually got a code from, I think, either Dulce Candy or Carly Bell. I got one of the codes, and it was actually really, really, a really good deal. So, it says that you can use three tries with it, up to three tries, but I've been using it, like, at least seven tries. It comes with one of these, the little gel, the little thing, and a little brush that I don't know where it's at. But what you do is you just apply it for 20 minutes, and it's supposed to whiten your teeth, I think, up to 4 to 7 shades. And I've actually really been liking it. Right now I'm just thinking about when the gel finishes. I don't know if I'm just gonna rebuy the gel or what's gonna happen. But anyways, I've actually really, really been liking it. So if you guys do have the chance to get it, maybe, possibly, you should try it if you do not want to keep trying these strips. Because those hurt my teeth. And those haven't hurt my teeth at all. Well, that hasn't hurt my teeth. Because I've actually used the white strips before, but how can I explain it? After like a week, I start feeling very like tingling my teeth, and I don't really like that. But that's basically it. I don't know what else to tell you guys. It wasn't that many products this month, just because I've been really busy. But definitely, if you guys want me to do any tutorials or anything like that, you guys should definitely, definitely let me know. I'm actually gonna start trying to hopefully buy new products, more drugstore products, just to kind of show you guys what I can do. Hopefully get some hair tutorials really soon. I do have a lot of updos that I know how to do, a lot of wave tutorials that I really want to show you guys. But I really just want to keep getting some feedback from you guys, just to see what you guys want to see from me. So I think that's basically it. Oh, one last thing. I was wondering if you guys wanted to see tags for me, like what's in my bag, something, I don't know, something else. But basically, just let me know what you guys want to see, and I'll gladly try to schedule it into whatever I want to do. So that's basically it, you guys. If you guys have any more questions, please let me know. Definitely, definitely subscribe. Keep watching my videos. Please tell your friends about them. I just really want to get your guys' feedback on everything. But that's basically it. Thank you guys for watching, and until next time, I'll see you guys later.